Be in the kitchen helping your mother. They'll be screaming for that baron of beef and three veg the moment that clock strikes seven.
Sing it again, sir.
Seen it? The clock?
No, sir. Her.
Her? Who?
The ghost.
Ghost? Where?
In Mozart.
Rubbish. I mean, you're perfectly well. There's no ghost in Mozart.
Yes, sir. No little girl. No crying in the night, no knockings on the walls.
Susan, there are no ghosts at Longreach. In Mozart or anywhere else, is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Hey.
Oh, my.
Oh, this is some joint.
It's very old. This is very old.
Very old, over 400 years now.
Really?
Oh, darling, this is Mr. and Mrs. Seagrove from Chicago. My husband, Sir Oliver Beresford.
How do you do, Mrs. Seagrove?
Lord Oliver.
Mr. Seagrove.
Hi.
Delighted to meet you. Let me see. Yes, we've put you in the Scarlatti room. We name all our bedrooms after famous classical composers. I'll show you out.
To Mozart, dear.
No, not Mozart, dear. No, the Scarlatti room.
There's a little plumbing problem in Scarlatti. It won't be fixed until tomorrow. I'm sure you'll adore Mozart.
I'm sure they'll adore Scarlatti, plumbing or no plumbing.
What's wrong with the Mozart room?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing at all.
In that case, Oliver, perhaps you'll show our guests up to Mozart.
Yes, of course, my dear. I don't know what I was going on about. That time of the month, you know.
Time of the month?
Full moon. Well, yes, I better go and see to your dinner. Good heavens. I must check the dining room for poltergeists who hang fresh garlic over the chimney piece.
I'll show you to your room.
We were told there might be other Americans staying.
Yes, we have two other couples. Uh-huh. There's Mr. and Mrs. Webster from New Jersey, and Mr. and Mrs. Masterson from Los Angeles.
Well, where did you spring from?
Will you help me?
Well, of course I will, darling. What's the problem?
Please come with me.
Well, right now, honey, I've got to get downstairs. We're due to have dinner. But if there's anything I can do later on, anything at all, you just let me know, okay?
It certainly is a fabulous place Lord Oliver has here.
Sir Oliver.
What?
He's a sir, not a lord.
You mean there's a difference?
Sure. And I got pretty extensive business interests downtown.
If we can't anymore, it would be too much for all of
us. We're more or less ready in there, sir.
Oh, good. Very. Splendid. Well, you're more or less on time, give or take an hour or two.
Well, I did have to get Mozart ready.
Don't remind me.
I suppose the problem is that Lady Beresford's never seen it. Funny how some people do and others don't.
Oh, hilarious. We'd all have a good laugh about it after lights out.
Bob Masterson, can I get you a drink?
Everything all right there, Mrs. Seagrove? Room to your satisfaction?
Yes, thank you.
Is it nice, this Mozart room?
Well, it's very quiet, wouldn't you say? And wonderful view.
Just lovely. I saw the sweetest little girl in my room. Is that your daughter? Was anything wrong?
Wrong? Oh, good heavens, though. But can I get you a drink?
Well, I'd love a dry sherry, please.
So you say a girl came into your room?
Yeah, she wanted me to help her with something. When I turned around, she'd gone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that'll be Ethel. A bit of a creep, really. She's always hanging around.
And she doesn't live here?
Good heavens, no.
You just creeps in and creeps out. You never know where you are with Ethel.
We're ready to serve, sir.
Right. Yes. Would you all like to go through, please? Mustn't keep cook waiting. My dear, will you show them through?
God, that's so old.
Yes, and take your drinks through with you.
Amazing to think. You don't waste any time, do you?
What's that supposed to mean?
Masterson. Took you all of 10 seconds to home in.
Joe, don't start all that again.
You're doing the starting.
Thank you, Sir Oliver.
My pleasure. Our pleasure, my wife and I. Bon appetit. Bottoms up.
Yeah.
Oh, if you should see that young girl again, Ethel, would you tell her I'll catch her later?
That's exactly what I'm afraid of.
Alice, you don't waste any time.
Joe, you really don't believe
what the hell's going on?
You're asking me, pal.
How dare you? In the next bed? My God!
Sharon, do I look crazy?
Yeah, sex crazy.
It was that little girl. She brought me here.
The one you told me about?
Oh, yeah.
She went in there.
Why would she go in there?
I don't know. But she needs help.
She's not the only one.
You must think I've just fallen off the Christmas tree.
Joe, it's the truth.
Oh, sure. If anyone else comes into our room in the middle of the night asking for help, I'll help them. All the way out of the goddamn window.
Listen, I'm terribly sorry. You gotta believe me. This is the same little girl that I saw yesterday. You know the one I tell you about? Well, this is...
Alice!
If I thought...
Huh. Sharon, they're both completely wacko.
Don't get smart with me, Robert.
More coffee, Mrs. Webster.
Thank you.
Mrs. Seagrove?
No, thank you.
You know, Mr. Seagrove, a pretty weird thing happened last night.
It was weird, all right.
No, I meant after you and Mrs. Seagrove went back to your bedroom.
Not now, Bob.
No, I just thought it might be interesting. I mean, they're just the six of us, right? We got another day and a night here together? Might as well be friendly.
Listen, pal, I don't go for that kind of friendliness.
Now, hold on a minute. I'm getting a little sick and tired of your innuendos.
You L.A. freaks are all the same.
I don't think I want to hear any more of this, Herman.
Damn right. Come on, Martha, let's go outside and get some fresh air.
Good morning, everyone. Getting in the mood for a jolly, jolly day. Ah, breakfast all right. Kidneys to your satisfaction. Coffee hot. Juice, juicy. Croissant, crisp.
Why do you have to be so damned aggressive?
Yes, well, I'll have to see what I can do about that.
I was talking to my husband.
Oh, splendid. Can't have enough of that.
I had a bit of a problem last night, Sir Oliver.
Oh, what a pity. Oh, still, I'm sure it's only temporary. It's probably just travel fatigue. I wouldn't worry about it, old man.
What the hell are you saying?
Mrs. Seagrove thought she saw a girl.
A girl? A girl? No, not. I haven't had a girl here for months, years. My wife won't allow them.
Mrs. Seagrove followed the girl into our bedroom, where she went into a closet and disappeared.
Tonight we're doing Snow White and the Seven Dwarves.
Let me see. I mean, how old would this girl be?
11. Fair hair. Wearing a sort of party dress. Well, it was the same girl I saw yesterday. You said her name was Ethel.
Oh, that girl! Oh, yes, of course, you mean Ethel. Oh, well, of course, that explains it.
11 years old, 2 o'clock in the morning, and that explains it?
Everyone had sufficient. Good. You can clear the table now, Susan. If you stand there any longer, you'll miss lunch. Oliver, see if you can find yourself something constructive to do.
Yes, of course, my sweet. A little carpentry, perhaps. Run up the odd coffin.
Well, we must be off. Check out the local village.
Wonderful antique shops.
Great.
It was an apparition, wasn't it?
No.
A psychic manifestation of a previous occupant of this house. Someone young, strong-willed, female, and very troubled.
Only an idiot believes in that kind of garbage.
It's not garbage, Joe. My mother was psychic. There was no doubt about that.
Yeah, she could sense a gin and tonic at 50 paces.
Don't start calling my mother a lush.
Perish the thought. Don't worry about ghosts, Mrs. Seagrove. The only strong-willed, troubled person around here has just gone out to do her karate exercises.
Are you coming?
Not right now.
I've seen it. The ghost.
Where?
Upstairs.
In the Mozart room once, and more often in that room the Mastersons are in, Beethoven.
Then it is a genuine ghost.
Yeah, it's been here for years.
If Lucinda hears you going on like this, you'll be for the chop, you know, about 10 seconds after she drops me.
Now, this girl is definitely in some kind of trouble. Why don't we go up to the room when the Mastersons are out and see if we can make contact?
Oh, I'll have to help with lunch.
Yes, thank you, Susan. You've done your bit. Thank you very much.
Could at least give it a try. My mother always maintained that our own vibrations are very important when making contact.
Yes, well, I won't be much use to you there. I'm afraid I hardly ever vibrate.
But why does this girl keep appearing? I mean, there's got to be a reason.
There is. My mother-in-law always swore she'd come back and haunt me.
As a little girl.
Camouflage.
What's that?
She's impatient with us.
I think I'm beginning to vibrate.
Oh, we're sorry. We heard voices and thought the Mastersons were...
None of our business, Martha. Come on.
Oh, no, we were just...
Excuse us.
We weren't...
Oh, yeah.
No, I mean, we were just... Confound it!
That is a pity.
I could put it more stronger than that.
Yes. She's definitely gone. Huh? Poor girl. Well, we'll leave it now.
Splendid idea.
We'll see if we can make contact later tonight.
Where have you been? What took you so long?
Oh, I tried to serve the pudding.
The pudding? Did you get it?
But this is all we've got.
Well, we're just going to have to hope that that's enough.
Why are we doing the Webster's room? Have you seen her in here?
I'm doing all the rooms. Better safe than sorry. Hold the chair.
Are you sure this is a good idea?
Have you got a better one?
No. But how do we know garlic even works?
I looked it up in the book.
Works on her demons, werewolves and vampires.
I don't think it works on ghosts.
Oh, why?
She's here.
She's gone.
Excuse me. Again.
Oh, Mrs. Webster. Good evening. We were just testing out the bed.
Well, I never believed what I read about the British aristocracy. Until now.
I confound it again.
Nobody is holding a seance in my bedroom.
It's in the Masterson's bedroom, Joe. And if they're going to cooperate, I don't see why you can't meet them halfway.
Not halfway across their bedroom.
Well, why do you have to...
He was at it again, Herman. That lord, with the maid this time.
It's none of our business, Martha.
When it's on our bed, it is, Herman.
Martha, what's a seance?
Don't you talk dirty, Herman.
Hi. I haven't had much of a chance to talk to you.
We're fine.
We wanted a quiet weekend.
Well, you've probably heard me talking to Joe, but as it happens, things may get a little lively later on.
Oh, yes?
I've spoken to Bob and Sharon Masterson now. They're all for it.
Are they now?
So, thought I'd ask you.
About what?
Whether you'd like to join in a little adventure later on.
Herman, let's get out of here. This is no place for us.
You don't like the idea?
I think it's disgusting.
Weirdos, the place is full of them.
Herman, look, I told you that
Lady Beresford gone to bed already, Sir Oliver?
Oh, yes. Nelly to bed, Helly to rise. That's my wife. Thank God. Well, another brandy, Mr. Seagrave.
Yeah, might as well.
Will you have that one on me, Joe?
Come on, Joe.
Sure, why not?
Cheers.
Well, I'm off to bed. I'll see you all a little later. Maybe.
No doubts about tonight?
Well, we'll see how it goes.
Your places away from the wardrobe. They've gone into the wrong room,
not the Websters.
And there's nothing to worry about, old chap. It just popped in.
What are you weirdos up to?
We should have got out of here.
Mrs. Webster, you don't understand. We're looking for a little girl.
Perverts. Do something, Herman.
She's getting excited.
Herman!
Get out of here, you loonies. We're not into your kind of games.
Mrs. Webster, we are just taking part in a psychic manifestation.
Not with me, you're not.
Oliver, what is going on?
They're sex mad, all of them.
My dear lady.
Especially him.
Oliver, it is after midnight. Would you kindly tell me what is going on?
And who have you locked in the wardrobe?
It's the ghost, Lady Beresford. We've been trying out a...
God, Herman, what kind of a place is this?
Told you time and time again, Susan, there is no ghost.
So who's doing the banging?
Possibly a tremor?
The vibrations are very angry.
You're probably picking up mine.
Yes, I'd be interested on having your opinion about that particular tremor, my dear.
I want to get out of this madhouse right now, Herman! You hear me, Herman? Right now!
What? Cover yourself!
First our room, now this. But that closet is right in line with ours next door. Maybe there's something hidden between them.
Yes, the old nursery.
Nursery?
The doors behind that wardrobe. It was bricked up for some reason many years ago before we came here.
In 1926, actually. Longreat Manor used to belong to the Hardens. They had a daughter, Belinda, who disappeared and was never seen again.
Belinda? Yeah. Yeah, that feels right.
What happened to her?
Well, no one knows. Her mother never recovered from the grief of losing her. She died in this very room in 1926. Her husband had the nursery walled up and became a recluse.
Oh, my God. Herman. Herman, why aren't you up?
Well, it's kind of interesting, Martha.
Interesting?
You mean you knew this all the time? Why didn't you tell me?
You're quite dotty enough as it is, Oliver. You better have a look in there tomorrow, I suppose.
I think we better do it now.
Well, you're not going to excavate in my room. We got this room until tomorrow.
Mrs. Webster, if we can only find out what's troubling this girl, we can free her from this house.
You can sleep by this Belinda kid's running around all night?
You're right, Herman. Break it down.
Jeez. Give her the creeps.
She's here.
Where?
Belinda? We're here to help you, Belinda. Belinda? Belinda? Belinda?
Why was that?
It seemed to be over there by the window.
Seeing this, am I, Herman? Tell me, Herman. I'm not really seeing anything.
You're not really seeing anything, Martha.
Wait a minute. I think this is hinged. Hey, didn't some of these old houses have a hiding place?
Yes, a priest's hole.
Hey, hey, there's a catch here.
In there for a game. Nobody could find her. She was here all the time.
She's gone now.
Are you sure?
Yes. Now we've found her. She's free.